Hey everybody, welcome back to Library Says. My name is Jamie, and today I'm going to tell you all about my most anticipated releases of May, June, July, and August 2020. I'm going to tell you what I know about these books, which for the most part is very little, because I'm trying not to spoil myself. I just initially saw a summary, saw a cover, and thought, that looks cool. I'm excited. So first up is The Life and Medieval Times of Kit Sweetly by Jamie Pacton. It comes out May 5th, and it is about a woman... girl, I don't actually know if this is adult or YA, who works at like a medieval times style show. Or maybe she works at medieval times. I don't know if you've ever been. You eat and they perform and you watch jousting and the whole thing. And I've never actually been, but there's one really close to me. I probably need to go there. I don't know anything else about it, except I think there's probably a romance element. And I just think it's a very cool concept. And I'm excited for it. Next up is By the Book by Amanda Sellett. This is a YA contemporary romance about a girl who loves classic literature and feels like she knows the ins and outs of the romance genre in classic novels. And so she creates a sort of survival guide for the different types of nefarious men, nefarious love interests that you might encounter and how to avoid them. And then she falls for the number one bad boy on her list. Yes, please. Yes. Thank you. Set me up. And the third and final book that I am anticipating on this list for May, it's Beach Read by Emily Henry. I actually already got and read the arc for this via NetGalley, and I loved it. It is a contemporary fiction slash romance about two authors who write very different genres. He writes sort of dark, depressing literary fiction. She writes women's fiction slash romance. They have beach houses next to each other and are both in reading slumps, decide to take on a challenge where they will write each other's genres to try and kind of get their writing mojo back. And it's pretty hate to love-ish, and it's hilarious. And anyway, sounds good, right? So even if I hadn't already read it, it would definitely be on this list, and it should be on yours too. Next up is June, and I have four titles in June I'm really looking forward to. The first one being Rage and Ruin by Jennifer L. Armentrout. This is the second in a YA fantasy series about gargoyle shapeshifter guardians. It's sort of a spinoff of one of her other series I haven't read, but I read the first book in the series and I loved it. There is a lot of action, there's a romance, there's some intrigue, mystery, deception. I'm super duper excited about the second one. Also coming out in June is The Air Affair by Heather Cox and Jessica Morgan. This is the sequel to The Royal We, which basically is fan fiction of Prince William and Kate and their courtship, falling in love, marriage woes. And this is a sequel to that that I think is centered on them having kids, thus The Air Affair. I loved the first one. I thought it was a lot of fun, and I have high hopes for the sequel. Next up is The Marriage Game by Sarah Desai. This is a romantic comedy, I think, about a woman who is set up on 10 blind dates by her dad, and then I think falls for one of them, even though she's very reluctant and stubborn and does not want to fall for one of them. And then it's this matter of like, is it a game or is it real? Is she really falling for him? I don't know much more than that and I don't want to. I just kind of want to dive in, but it looks like it's a lot of fun and its early reviews have been really, really good. Then I have The Red Point Crux by Morgan Chamey. This is a romantic thriller mystery, I think, inspired by Phantom of the Opera, about a woman who injures herself on the Olympic climbing team or the American climbing team, something like that, and joins a ballet, and then murders start happening, and then she meets a man who lives under the school. That's all I know. Phantom of the Opera, I'm a big fan. Very excited. I think this one's going to be very interesting. Then I have two titles I'm really anticipating that come out in July. First off is The Princess Will Save You by Sarah Henning. This is the first in a YA fantasy series that sort of sounds like a twist on The Princess Bride, about a princess who is also trained as a warrior who falls in love with a stable boy, but the stable boy gets kidnapped and she is going to go save him. Great. Sounds great. And then I'm excited about Heartbones by Colleen Hoover that comes out on the 28th. I literally know nothing about this, except Colleen Hoover has said it is a romance. Colleen Hoover used to write romance, and I used to love them. I have not liked her more recent stuff at all, but I am very eager to read a book that she herself is calling romance again. Like back to the old days, maybe? I literally know nothing, though, and it's called Heartbones, so And then I have two titles I'm anticipating in August. The first is 50-50 by Steve Cavanaugh that comes out on the 11th. This is a book in a long, long series of mystery thrillers that I have not read. I have only read the book before this one that came out last year. It's called 13, that was about a serial killer who worked his way onto juries of trials against people who were being falsely accused for his crimes. It was just the coolest concept. So I picked it up and I read it, and it worked perfectly well as a standalone. I didn't feel like I needed any context at all. This next one, I don't even remember what it's about, but I liked 13 so much, I thought, I'm gonna give the next one a go. And so I'm going to. But I'm probably not ever gonna go back and reread the rest of the series. I doubt it. And then the very last book, it's coming out in August. It's Where Dreams Descend by Janella Angelis. This is the first in a fantasy duology about members of a circus who do magic as part of a competition. Sounds kind of like the Night Circus. But it's called Startling and Romantic in its synopsis. And I'm gonna give it a go, because I think that sounds cool. So that's it. Those are the books I am most anticipating over the next 4 months. If you're interested in seeing what's on my TBR for upcoming months, I have them all organized by shelves on my Goodreads, which you can find down below. I'd love to hear if you've gotten advanced copies of any of these and read any of them, what you thought, or any other books that maybe I missed out on that you think I should know about. Otherwise, I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video. Bye.